Now, the National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions, Bill 2020. Dr. Harshvardhan, to move a motion for consideration of the National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions, Bill 2020.
Respected sir, I rise to move that National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions Bill 2020 be taken into consideration.
Motion moved.
Sir, like in the previous bill, I'll just take 5 to 10 minutes to just briefly summarize what we are intending to do, because it has already been considered by the department-related standing committee also in great detail. Sir, this bill, which was introduced in this House on 15th of September 2020, sir, it's a path-breaking initiative that has the potential to change the future of healthcare service delivery for both the people of this country and also the allied and healthcare professionals. While doctors, nurses, dentists, and pharmacists in India are regulated through their respective regulatory bodies, the allied and healthcare professionals are still unstructured and unregulated. In the global landscape, many countries have notified a statutory structure to regulate the education and practice of such allied and healthcare providers. The potential of these professionals can be utilized to reduce the cost of care and to make quality healthcare services accessible to all. Sir, several committees, starting from Bhore Committee in 1948, have stressed on the importance of quality human resource for health with the right skills and training. Similarly, there has been an increased momentum globally to align with the 2030 human resources for health goals. In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic also, the critical and life-saving role of allied and healthcare professionals was very well established. The invaluable role of respiratory therapists, laboratory technologists, psychologists, and physician associates, among several others during these past months, cannot be overstated. The need for development and maintenance of standards of services and education of such professionals through a national regulatory body has thus been long overdue. Sir, I feel happy to state that since coming into power in 2014 and after extensive deliberations with all stakeholders, we introduced a bill to this effect in the Rajya Sabha during the winter session of 2018. The same was thoroughly examined by the department-related parliamentary standing committee for health and family welfare, and based on the recommendations made by the 117th Department-related Parliamentary Standing Committee on the lines of the National Medical Commission, my department carried out all necessary changes and a fresh bill titled the National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions Bill 2020 has been introduced now. The bill will cover 56 professional profiles which are logically organized under 10 professional councils. Sir, we have ensured that the bill clearly specifies the description of each category to demarcate practice boundaries. Broadly, allied health professionals are those who undergo minimum 2,000 hours and 2 to 4 years of training, and healthcare professionals are those who attain at the minimum of 3,600 hours or 3 to 6 years of education and training. Sir, in order to further preserve their identity and the degree of complexity of the services delivered by them, all the professions have been coded as per the International Labour Organization's ILO, International Standard for Classification of Occupation, ISCO 8, so as to allow them for global recognition and mobility. So within the bill, We have also kept a provision for constitution of 10 professional councils for different professions at the national level, so that the professionals can ensure their direct interventions for best standards in their respective professions. The Commission, however, in a totality, will be ensuring that the standards recommended by the professional councils align with the larger norms and goals. Thus, the Central Commission would be entrusted with developing the policy, standards and guidelines based on the recommendations from individual professional councils under its ambit and in consultation with other national regulatory bodies. Just 1-2 minutes more, sir. While the state councils would be expected to ensure implementation and enforcement of such regulations. The bill also has a provision for registration of all the existing professionals. Further, as there are no statutory bodies in states which holistically cover the entire gamut of allied and healthcare professionals, existing professional councils at state level pertaining to the recognized categories would be subsumed and their mandate would be expanded to all to cover the professions. National Allied and Healthcare Advisory Council, with representation from all the states, has also been proposed to enable adequate representation from all states. Further, each state will be having a separate state council with 4 autonomous boards pertaining to undergraduate education, postgraduate education, assessment and rating, and ethics and registration. The bill provides for task shifting, that is, moving specific tasks to specialized allied and healthcare professionals for better recognition of health workforce and improved healthcare. The National Commission and State Councils formed on enactment of the National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions Bill 2020 will provide an opportunity to regulate and leverage the qualified allied and healthcare workforce and ensure high quality multidisciplinary care in line with the vision of universal health coverage, moving towards a more care accessible and team-based model. Sir, as I lay this bill on the table and request all the members to consider it, I request all my colleagues to support this bill, not only to fructify the efforts and progress made till now, but also for the greater good and healthy future of this nation. Thank you.
Thank you. Motion moved.